Our next guest is a relationship expert about SOs, and she contends that there are three myths that sabotage relationships. She also says there are a few things that you must know now if you want to master a constructive argument with your significant other, because we know they can go one of two ways.
Yeah, exactly. They can be constructive or destructive.
Exactly.
Right? All right, Barb Bartlein is here with tips on having a great relationship. She is a psychotherapist, a professional speaker, an author, a musician. She's also a mother and as a nurse, and she wrote this book, Why Did I Marry You Anyway? I gave this to my parents. My dad goes, why did you give mom this book? She also offers couples classes for couples. We'll tell you about in just a second. Great
good to see you.
Your hair is so long now. It looks beautiful.
Well, thank you. I just stopped cutting it. I don't know why. Everybody asks me why, but I save $100 a month.
There you go. Does your husband like long hair?
Well, I think he's having an affair. And I'll tell you why, because he's after me all the time. And he says I'm like a new woman.
With your long hair?
With my long hair.
Oh, that's so interesting.
I think guys love long hair. I had this conversation the other day, and I really do. I think they like it.
I can tell you he likes it. He says, oh, it's like another whole lady in my life.
That is so cute. Good for you for switching it up.
Uh-huh.
Let's talk about first the top three things that people fight about. You said this to us before on the show, but tell us what those three things are.
Money.
Yes.
Always money. Okay. Number one thing couples fight about.
Yes.
Sex.
And
children.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Children.
That's interesting.
I was surprised in-laws wasn't on the list.
Actually, people don't fight that much about in-laws. Maybe
that's
in
good.
The beginning,
yeah.
But pretty soon you decide you either like them or don't like them, and you set a boundary.
You deal
that's,
with it.
Yeah, that's actually one of the easier battles.
Mm.
Interesting. Okay. You say also, related to the sex thing, is it usually frequency?
Let's just go over the averages, shall we?
Okay.
The average for married people, any guess how many times per week?
Once.
Twice. But
oh, really?
Yeah, twice
okay.
is the average.
That's pretty good.
You know?
Yeah.
Okay, average duration of the act.
2 minutes. I'm just kidding.
Five to five? I was going to say 5 to 10 minutes, but.
Yeah, you both are real close. It's 7 minutes.
Yeah.
Whoa.
7 minutes.
There's not a lot of, David Borkleister always talks about the warm-up. The climax, the cool down. There's not a lot of warm up if it's 7 minutes.
He's talking minutes. About that in terms of events, by the way.
Good
guess
point.
Where she took it. He talks about that all the time. Yes, when you're planning an event, you gotta warm them up.
I just
cool them off.
Honk laughed, and I wonder about the closed captioner. How she translates that? Does she write honk?
You should tell her how. How would you like her to translate that?
Because everybody calls it a honk.
Call it a honk.
All right, there you go, Pam. You got that? Okay. All right. So that's interesting. Two building blocks of long-term relationships. What are they?
Trust and commitment.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Marriage is not based on love.
No.
Yeah, because it's
agreed.
Fascinating. You say love is not enough.
Oh, absolutely not enough. I mean, there's days, let's face it, I've been with Charlie 37 years. There's days you get up, you don't even like them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let alone love them. You know, it's a commitment that holds you together. And when you work on that commitment, the love grows.
Mm-hmm.
People have that backwards. They think, oh, we'll chase the love and the commitment will grow. No, you work on the commitment.
Mm-hmm. I think that's a great point for people. I'm sad that we moved on from sex already, but however.
We can go back.
We can go back.
Okay, so money, though, that's another thing that you wanted to kind of touch on.
Well, money represents a lot of things in a relationship, including power, control.
Mm-hmm.
People have different money personalities.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But research has shown over and over again, if you want to be comfortable someday, you have to be one of two types for the future. Either a planner or a saver.
Mm-hmm.
People that are impulsive and just spend money whenever they want, they might be fun to hang around with when you're dating, not so fun when you're married.
Right.
And they come home with a new car you knew nothing about. Not a good plan.
Mm-hmm.
What I often tell couples, there's many ways to handle the money. It's all right, but you need to have somebody be a planner or a saver.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. You also talk about patterns of communication that people have in a relationship, and especially as it relates to arguing, I guess, but and developing positive habits as it relates to that.
Right, right. Well, one of the things that I encourage couples to do is set up some ground rules.
Mm-hmm.
How do you want it to look at your house? One of the ground rules we have at our house is you can't bring up museum pieces. You can't bring up things from the past.
Old.
You can't be
mm-hmm.
stamp collecting and then regurgitate that in the next argument. We don't allow that. And that has eliminated a lot of arguing. Like my husband says, we always have new things to argue about. Why bring things up from the past? That's a great point. It works.
One of the arguing, I guess it could be a technique that I learned that I think works well, is not using the word I or you. You know, taking the word you out, I guess it should be. You know, so you're never saying you did this or you right. do this or you make me feel this. No, these are things that I feel or I don't like or whatever, and kind of taking that back so that you're not making the blame a problem.
Right, right. Stopping. Some people call it the blame game,
yeah.
where somebody else is always at fault for what happened.
Right.
Usually mm-hmm. your partner, usually your spouse.
Mm-hmm.
And so when you back off from that, it's a whole different dynamic.
I also think words like never and always,
yeah.
like you always do this.
Yeah.
Or
take
you
them out.
Never, you got to take those words out. Myths in relationships can sort of destroy feelings and intimacy. Are there some myths about relationships that people hold on to that are not positive?
Well, I think a lot of people still believe the myth in America of living happily ever after, finding the knight on the shining white horse, you know, and it, let me tell you, they all get up and pass gas. They do it, you know? They do it.
Ain't that the truth? Right, right.
You know, we're just people, and we have pluses and we have minuses, and I think part of a healthy relationship is not only being tolerant of those idiosyncrasies the other person has, but enjoying them and celebrating them.
Mm-hmm.
That's cute.
Yeah,
I like that. All right, what do you want to say about the classes that you offer?
I am offering an online class in couples counseling. It's either for people that are studying to be a counselor or already are a counselor, or couples that want to improve their relationship.
Okay, and
that's great.
That's through UWM School of Continuing Education, right?
Correct.
Okay, so if people correct. Go to themorningblend.com, to our website, you can follow the link there for Barb Bartlein's couples counselor training. Registration does close, though, the 1st of August, so make sure you do that right away. Great to see you.
It's good to see both of you.
You're like a whole new woman.
Yeah, I walked in the studio, I was like, Barb, with the long hair.
Uh-huh.
You look great.
Yeah.
Have a wonderful
Thanks,
summer.
Barb.
Thanks
you
for
too.
Being here.